So students, today we are going to learn a new chapter, that is structural organization in animals. This is the last retained chapter I have to teach. Okay, so this is the last chapter I have to teach in retained portion. So structural organization in animals, meaning how body of the organism or body of the animal is designed, like what all parts are there inside the body, what our body contains, what all organization is there, how cells are arranged or organized, how tissues are organized, what are the different types of tissues, okay, like what is the morphology of the body, what is the internal part, anatomy of the body, all that we are going to learn in this chapter. Okay, so first when we start with this, we have to start with tissues, different types of animal tissues. Okay, you can see a tissue means already you know it's a group of cells with similar structure and function. Means like cells of kidney, they have same function, that is filtration of blood. All the cells of heart have one function, that is blood circulation. So like that, cells present in one particular organ, all the cells will do same function. So group of cells with similar structure and similar function. So all the cells present in the heart should have same shape. And all the cells present in the liver should have same shape and size also. So group of cells with similar structure and function we call tissue. You already know this, I have already explained it, because we have learned plant tissues. At that time tissue definition I already told you. So animal tissues are of four types. First one is epithelial tissue, that forms the outer skin or outer cover of body and all organs. Then connective tissue, which connects different parts of the body, like muscles and bones will be connected, connective tissue. Then blood is a liquid connective tissue. So connective tissue is the second type of animal tissue, and third type is muscular tissue, you know, muscles. And fourth type is neural tissue, all nerves are there. So animal tissues are of four types: epithelial tissue, connective tissue, muscular tissue and neural tissue. Next, first we will see epithelial tissues, which forms the outer cover of the body and outer cover of the organs, like a skin. Okay, so it has a free surface that faces body fluid and outside the environment. Free surface means it forms the outer cover of the organ or outer cover of the body. Okay, it faces the body fluid and outside environment, means inside it will face blood or body fluid, outside it will face a skin. Like you take skin as epithelial tissue, outside it faces environment and inside it faces blood, no, body fluid. No, inside the skin blood is there, outside the skin environment is there. So like that, covers or lines the body or body parts. Epithelial tissue means it is a outer skin or outer layer which covers either entire body, that is skin, or it covers all the organs. Okay, cells are compactly packed with little intercellular space. You can see that cells are very tightly packed. In between the cells there is no space, no intercellular space. You can see that they are showing, this is one type of tissue, all the cells are tightly packed, no space. Here also no space, here also no space. You can see 1 2 3 4 5 1 2 3 4 5 6, so 6 plus 5 11 cells are there, but in that 11 cells there is no gap between the cells. Andre eradu cells madhyadalli gap illa, so no intercellular space. Either you call it as epithelial tissue or epithelium, both are same. Okay, so epithelial tissues are of two types mainly. Epithelial tissues are of two types depending on how many cells are arranged in how many layers. Like simple epithelial tissue, when it is single layered, you can see here the cells are arranged only in one layer. Like you consider in a classroom only first bench students, okay, they are arranged in one layer, then it is simple epithelial tissue. That is simple epithelial tissue means single layered. If there are multi layered, like more than one line is there, or cells are arranged one above the other, forms many layers, then it becomes compound epithelial tissue. That is multi-layered. You can see here, this is one layer, this is second layer, this is third layer, fourth layer, fifth layer, sixth layer, seventh layer, like that they are arranged. So epithelial tissues are of two types. If they are single layered, then they are called simple. If they are multi-layered, then they are called compound. So simple epithelial tissue and compound epithelial tissue. Now we will see first one, simple epithelial tissue. There are again types, okay? That is, simple epithelial tissues are having single layer of cells. Already we learned just now, it lines body cavities, ducts and tubes. Means what all parts it covers, it lines body cavities, whatever space is there inside the body. And nam dehadalli ellello ellelli khali jagagalide aa jagagalannella cover madutha. It covers the cavities of the body, ducts, the tubes, like blood vessels, like blood vessel, artery, veins, all that outer cover it forms. Okay, then based on the structural modification, simple epithelium is of three types. Meaning based on modification in the structure, means how the cells are modified, how it has modified structure, based on that three types, like squamous epithelium, cuboidal epithelium, columnar epithelium. You can see that depending on shape of the cell, you see that squamous epithelium, first one, it looks like a mattress, you know, bed mattress. It's like a bed, like we use bed for sleeping, like that. Exactly looks like a mattress, no, where cells are arranged in one layer in all three cases, because it is a type of simple epithelium. But difference is what you see, shape of the cell, shape of every cell is different. In squamous epithelial tissue, all the cells are flat and pressed. And in case of cuboidal epithelial tissue, cells are like cube-like structure, that is bun, not bread. Bun, I think you have seen, bun, no? It is almost like a bun, like every cell looks like a bun, no? That is called cuboidal structure. So it is called cuboidal epithelium. If the cells are long, you see there, this is one cell, this long. So cells are very long there, so it forms a long column-like structure, so it is called columnar epithelium. Next, simple epithelium, where and all it is present? In simple epithelium, already we learnt, based on the structural modification, three types. Squamous epithelium, that is, cells are arranged like a mattress, no? Cells are arranged, flattened cells, single layered, okay, that is called squamous epithelium. Where this squamous epithelium is present? So you can see the flattened cells, cells are like a mattress or bed, flat, pressed from both the sides. Okay, their layer is flattened cells with irregular boundaries. There is no particular, like a straight line boundary you can draw. It is like a wave like. So there is no particular boundary. Where it is found in our body? Squamous epithelium is found in the wall of the blood vessels and lung alveoli. So wall of the blood vessel, you know, blood vessel is like a tube. The wall of the blood vessel is made of squamous epithelial tissue and also lung alveoli. So inner wall of alveoli, they are showing here, this is alveoli present in the lungs. Okay, so inner wall, you can see here they have written squamous epithelial tissue here, and this epithelial tissue is required for exchange of gases. So it is present in the blood vessels, then in the lung of alveoli. What is the function? Forms a diffusion boundary. Diffusion means movement of molecules from higher to lower concentration occurs through squamous epithelium. That is, exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide between alveoli and blood happens. You have learnt in respiration chapter. For that exchange of gases, this layer, the membrane of alveoli, contains squamous epithelial tissue. Next, then in the wall of nephron, that is PCT and DCT. In PCT and DCT, what kind of epithelial tissue is there? That is cuboidal epithelial tissue is there. You can see cells are like a cube-like structure, like a bun. Okay, cube-like structure composed of cube-like cells. That is why it is called cuboidal. Found in the ducts of glands and tubular part of nephrons. Means in the nephron, like wherever glands are there in the nephron, which produces hormone, then wherever tubes are there, like PCT, DCT, then CT, collecting tube, all that contains, you see here, this is collecting tube, it contains cuboidal cell, and PCT also contains cuboidal cell, DCT also contains cuboidal cell, then endless loop also contains cuboidal cell. So all the inner wall of the tube of nephron contains cuboidal epithelium. Cells are like a cube. What is their function? Secretion and absorption. You know, PCT, DCT, endless loop are involved in secreting some chemicals, like potassium is secreted, you know. So for secretion, then absorption, that is selective reabsorption occurs there. Whatever is required, it will reabsorb. So secretion and absorption, and a small quantity of urea is also secreted there, you know. So secretion means production of some chemicals, and absorption of the chemicals is because of cuboidal epithelium. So it is present in epithelium of PCT and nephron as microvilli, means small finger like structures, that is called microvilli. Small finger like structures will be there, that is for absorption. Okay, same like in the inner wall of small intestine has finger like structure called villi. Here it is very small, called microvilli. Next, where is columnar epithelium present? Like cells are long, elongated like a column. And kambathara irthanta, like a pillar. Long, elongated cells, they are tall and slender, means very narrow, tall, slender cells. The nuclei are located at the base. You can see the nuclei is present at the base of the cell. Andre adra nucleus cell na kelagade irthadu, lower part of the cell. Then free surface may have microvilli, like upper and lower surface will have finger like structures. You can see here, this is villi, no, this is lumen of stomach and intestine. It is found in the inner lining of stomach and intestine. The nama hotte olagade bhaga matte intestine na olagade bhaga dalli long elongated columnar cells will be there. That means inner wall of the stomach and intestine contains columnar epithelium, so it will have finger like structures called villi. Okay, this is one villi where it is present on the inner part of the tube. Like this is a tube, on the inner part of the tube there will be villi. So meant for secretion and absorption, like it secretes many hormones like gastrin, then cholecystokinin, all that what we have learnt in last class in under chemical coordination chapter. Okay, then meant for absorption of digested food. Digested food will be absorbed. So secretion and absorption is a function. Then modification of columnar and ciliated epithelium. Sometimes columnar cells and cuboidal cells will have slight modification. Small changes will be there. What is that change? You can see that is columnar cells but having a hair like structures on the top, that is called cilia. You know, cilia, flagella, you know, cilia. There, this is a long cell, cuboidal cell, sorry, columnar cell with cilia. Okay, where it is present, you can see that they have written cells bear cilia on the free surface, present at the inner side of hollow organs like bronchioles and fallopian tubes. Meaning this type of ciliated epithelium is present in the bronchioles, that is the tubes which supplies oxygen, I mean exchange of gases in the lungs. You know, first there will be trachea, that is windpipe, then divides into bronchus, then bronchus divides into many bronchioles. So inner wall of the bronchioles and inner wall of the fallopian tube, that is a female reproductive part in humans. Fallopian tube, two structures are there like this, not tube like structure. Inner wall contains hair like structures, that is columnar ciliated epithelium. Columnar ciliated because it has hair like structure called cilia. Okay, they are showing there in the bronchioles, you can see this hair like structure called cilia. Then in the fallopian tube, these tubes, this is on left side and right side tubes, inner part contains ciliated epithelium. That was a modification of columnar cell. Then, sometimes columnar cells will be called as glandular epithelium. Glandular, because some of the columnar cells will form a glands. Okay, like you see there. For secretion, they are of two types, unicellular and multicellular. Meaning, unicellular means consists of isolated glandular cells like goblet cells of alimentary canal. You can see here, these are the glands. Okay, every cell has a gland there. One cell has one gland, so it is unicellular glands, like for example, goblet cells of alimentary canal. That is, alimentary canal means, you know, goblet cells of stomach and intestine, then esophagus, all the tubes. Okay, special glands. Then you can see here, many glands are there, like this one blue color, what you see here, one gland, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18 glands are there in this structure. Wherever you see these blue color dots, that is all one cell. It consists of cluster of cells. Cluster means group of cells. Okay, like salivary gland, which produces saliva in the mouth. Bayali, lala rasa, in the mouth, watery, what we get, that is saliva. It will be produced by salivary glands that contains group of glands. Okay, that is salivary gland. Either it is unicellular or it is multicellular. Then, some more examples if we see for glandular epithelium. In the eyes here, there is tear glands, which produces tear, no? That is called lacrimal glands, which produces tear. There is kannali kanneer bartadala, kanneerina granthi. Granthi andre gland. Okay, so that produces tear. That is also, you can see here, they are showing human eye, and this red color, what they are showing is lacrimal sac and lacrimal duct. So it's a lacrimal gland which produces tear. Okay, that is also glandular epithelium. Based on the mode of pouring of their secretions, glands are of two types. Pouring means filling the liquid. Andra liquid ani yav riti tumkolutade olagade, how it fills the liquid. So based on that, it is two types: exocrine glands, endocrine glands. You know already what is the meaning. Exocrine means it is ducted gland, where glands release their secretion and it passes through definite tubes. But endocrine means it is ductless gland, there are no tubes, directly it is released into the bloodstream. Okay, like they, exocrine glands secrete mucus, you know, in the nose, mucus, saliva, ear wax, oil on the skin, milk in the breast, digestive enzymes, no, in the stomach. All that is produced by exocrine glands. Means glands produce it, they pass through definite tubes. Then endocrine glands produce hormones, you know this. Okay, they are also glandular epithelium only. We will go to next slide. So one type of epithelium we finished, that is, which is made of single layered cells, that is called simple epithelium. What if cells are arranged in multi layers, like cells are arranged in many layers, then it is called compound epithelium. It is composed of multi-layered cells. You can see here, this is one layer, this is second layer, this is third layer, fourth layer, fifth layer. Okay, so it is multi-layered cells. Limited role in secretion and absorption. Means very less role is there in secreting some chemicals and absorbing the chemicals. They cover dry surface of the skin. Means wherever dry surface is there in the skin, they cover compound epithelium. Moist surface of the buccal cavity, that is inner throat, you know what is there, that is buccal cavity, throat part, the moist part, wet part of the buccal cavity. That's why they are showing here, no, inner part here, very smooth wet layer in the buccal cavity. Okay, in the throat portion. Then pharynx inner part, then where we swallow, then inner lining of ducts of salivary glands, inner lining of salivary glands and pancreatic duct, the tube which supplies hormones from the pancreas to the intestine, there also compound epithelium is present. What is their function? Protection against chemical and mechanical stress. Because it is many layered cells, it can provide protection from protection against chemical and mechanical stress. Like if you punch any person, nothing happens to his skin because skin is it will have multi-layered cells. Okay, so next, in between the cells sometimes gap will be there. Okay, that is called junctions. So that they are called cell junctions. You can see there cell junctions. These are the junction meaning meeting point. Like a road also will have junction, means where more than one road joins, like two roads join or three roads join, sometimes four to five roads join at one point. You call it as a circle, circle, or it is a junction, it is called, where traffic signal, where three, four roads join at one point, that is a junction. So where two cells or more than two cells join at one point, then it is called a junction. Okay. So they provide structural and functional links between the adjacent cells. Means how one cell is linked to other cell. You see, this is one cell and this is other cell. So here two cells are there. How they are linked in the center, you can see. So based on method of linking, based on how two cells are linked. Andre, eradu cells hege attach aagthade, eradu cells hege adhere aagthade, andre bind aagthade annodakke. The gap between the two cells, this is one cell, this is the other cell, this is a gap between the cell. How they join, that meeting point between two cells, we call junctions, cell junctions. Junction means meeting point of two cells. Okay, there are three types of cell junctions, like tight junctions, adhering junctions and gap junctions. Tight junction means where cells bind very tightly, very closely. Okay, that is tight junction. You can see here, this is a tight junction where two cells are bound very tightly. Okay, then second one, adhering junction. The word adhere means to attach or bind. Adhere andre kannadalli antikolludu athwa serudu anta meaning. Okay, adhering junctions, that is you can see here, this is a adhering junction. Okay, then gap junction. This is a gap junction, that is like a plasmodesmatal connection is there, like connection between two cells where materials from one cell can pass to next cell through a hole. Okay, through a opening, that is a gap junction. Okay, so three types of junctions are there between cells. So here clearly you can see it. Tight junction, where this is a tight junction, where help to stop substance from leaking across a tissue. Meaning, in between the cells, if any material is secreted or any liquid is secreted, the liquid doesn't leak. Leaking will be stopped by tight junctions because they are bound very tight, no gap there, so that the liquid cannot leak. Then second, adhering junction. This is adhering junction, means binding. Perform cementing to keep neighboring cells together. Means two cells should not separate. Two cells should come together. That's why they act like a gum or they act like a cement to bind two cells. Then third, gap junctions. It facilitates to communicate each other by connecting cytoplasm. Okay, like transfer of ions, small molecules, big molecules. This is nothing but plasmodesmata. That is, any liquid or any chemical can move from one cell to other cell through plasmodesmatal connection. That is a hole or gap between two cells. That is called gap junction. Next, we are going to learn about connective tissue, meaning like a gum, it connects different parts of the body. Like what all connective tissues are there, you can see there, bone, muscles will be joined. Okay, different type of connective tissues they are showing. Now we will learn types one by one. What is the main function of connective tissue? It links and supports other tissues or organs. Links means, like suppose bone and muscle, how they attach each other. Any gum is there,
it is bound by connective tissues. It acts like a gum. So it links and also supports other tissues and organs. So all the organs and tissues will be linked and joined by connective tissue. Most abundant in complex animals. Like in higher animals, these type of connective tissues are very common. Okay. Then all connective tissue except blood have fibroblast cells. Blood is also connective tissue. It is called liquid connective tissue or fluid connective tissue. Okay, because it flows. Except blood, means other than blood, remaining all the connective tissue will contain cells called fibroblasts. Okay, they secrete fibrous proteins. Fibrous means thread-like proteins called collagens and elastin. You see there. Okay, you can see this thread-like structure. No? So, that thread-like structure is produced by special cells of connective tissue called fibroblast. Name only says fibroblast. Word fiber means thread. Fiber andre dara. Okay, they produce thread-like structures called collagen and elastin. You know that collagen is the most abundant tissue in animals. No? In plants it is Rubisco enzyme. So collagen is a thread-like structure, and even elastin also. Elastin gives flexibility to body parts. Flexibility, like we can bend some areas. No, see, I'm rotating it. Neck portion we can rotate. All that is because of that flexible tissue, that is elastin. What is their function? They give strength, elasticity, and flexibility to the tissue. Okay, we can stretch our body parts. Okay, then we have flexible body parts. See, I'm moving it. Okay, this is all because of connective tissue. They give strength to the body, and they give elasticity, flexibility to the body. They also secrete modified polysaccharides. Means, in between these thread-like structures, what is this tissue called? That is called matrix. So they also secrete modified sugar or polysaccharide, that is called matrix, which accumulate between the cells and fibers. Means in between the cells, means gap between the cells, and that collagen and elastin, that is thread-like structure, in between that there will be a tissue called matrix. Okay, so what are the different types of connective tissues? Different types of connective tissues. Like, connective tissues are mainly three types. Loose connective tissue, where tissue is arranged very loosely. Then, dense connective tissue, means connective tissue is arranged very densely or thick. Gap is less there. Here you can see gap is there. This is loose connective tissue. This is dense. There is no gap. Very less gap is there. Then specialized connective tissues are there. You know, specialized connective tissues. So what all are these? We will see. Under loose connective tissue, there are two types: areolar connective tissue, adipose tissue. Under loose connective tissue, two types: areolar connective tissue and adipose tissue. Then under dense connective tissue, there are two types: dense regular and dense irregular. Dense regular and dense irregular. Then specialized connective tissues are there, like cartilage, you know. So in the ear, in the nose, no, this tip of the nose, then ear, hard part. It looks like a bone, but it is not a bone, it's a cartilage. So here also it's a cartilage. So cartilage, then bone is also connective tissue only. Okay, bone, but it is a special connective tissue. Bone, then blood is a fluid connective tissue or liquid connective tissue. So connective tissue are of three types: loose connective tissue, dense connective tissue, and special connective tissue. Under loose connective tissue, there are two types, that is areolar tissue and adipose tissue. Under dense connective tissue, dense regular, dense irregular. Under specialized tissue, bone, blood, and cartilage. Okay, three are there. So we will learn now one by one. first one, loose connective tissue, where you can see gap is there. This is areolar tissue and this is adipose tissue. This is areolar tissue, this is adipose tissue. So first one, loose connective tissue. In these cells, fibroblasts are there, fibroblasts, macrophages and mast cells are present. We will see any picture is there, like, yeah, you can see here. So in areolar connective tissue, you can see all this. That is, this green color part, what you see, it is called fibroblast, where fibroblast produces a thread-like structure. You can see like a rod-like structure it produces, that is collagen fibers. Then this is a mast cell, you can see there. Then this red color cell is macrophage. That is why they said it contains fibroblast, which produces thread-like structure. This fibroblast produces a thread-like structure called collagen and elastin fibers. Then this special structure is called mast cell, M-A-S-T, mast cell, and that red color cell is called macrophage. So this is areolar connective tissue. I'll go to previous slide, we were discussing it. That is, it contains fibroblasts, macrophages and mast cells, etc. And fibers means thread-like structures loosely arranged in a semi-fluid matrix. You can see here, these are the thread-like structures there. Okay, they are arranged loosely. You can see the gap there. It looks white here in between. That is a gap that is called semi-fluid matrix. Okay, semi-fluid matrix. You already know the gap between the fibers we call matrix. Okay, they are of two types. So loose connective tissue are of two types. They are called loose connective tissue because cells are arranged very loosely. So they are of two types, areolar tissue and adipose tissue. This is first one, that is areolar connective tissue. Exactly under microscope it looks like this, but this is a textbook picture. In textbook they are showing like this, the areolar tissue. Okay, this is a rod like fibroblast cell. Then fibroblast cell produce collagen and elastin fibers. You can see this blue color rod like structure or thread like structure, that is called collagen fibers. Then the red color cell is called macrophage. Then this is mast cell. You know, mast cell and all are required during allergic reactions are produced by mast cells. It produces some chemicals. Okay, then in between these cells, what you see here, that is a matrix. Okay, so you see in areolar connective tissue, cells are arranged loosely. Gap is there between all these cells, and the tissue present in between these cells are called matrix. No, this is a mast cell. This is fibroblast, which produces collagen and elastin fiber. Then that red color cell is macrophage. I think fifth time I repeated this. Okay, so next loose connective tissue is called adipose tissue. You can see under microscope, under electron microscope, you can see this adipose tissue. No? So in zooming, after zooming or magnified view, you can see ball like structures it looks. So these, each ball like structure is one cell, that's why they are showing. See, this big is one cell, and this black color dot, you what you see, that is nucleus. This is one big cell. Okay, the cytoplasm they are showing in yellow color. The inner liquid of the cell is what they are showing in yellow color, that is matrix. So this is a outer layer of the cell, that is membrane. Can you tell me how many cells are there in this picture? Here this is half cell, this is half cell, this is half cell, this is also half cell, this is also half cell. So you can see five cells there, which is half. Okay, no entire cell they are showing, because this is just a one part of it. Where you can see adipose tissue is meant for storing fat in our body. Wherever fat is there, now what you call charbi, ade kobbu antirala neevu kannadadalli, avanige thumba kobbide anta, that is adipose tissue. Okay, sometimes you say that person has lot of charbi, no? So that is, in these cells fat will be stored, all the fat will get stored. Like you, some people will have family pack, no? That is big belly. In that area, they will have extra fat. That fat is stored in these cells. That is called adipose tissue or adipose cells. Okay, this is a nucleus, and these cells are meant for storing fat. And this is a plasma membrane. See, they are mainly beneath the skin. Under the skin, lot of fat will be there. Under the skin, lot of fat will be there. That fat is because of adipose tissue. And the cells are called adipocytes. The cells of adipose tissue are called adipocytes. Because you know word C-Y-T-E, site means cell. Cytology means study of cells. So adipocytes are the cells of adipose tissue. The main function of these cells is to store fat. So if you have fat in your body, that is under the skin, that is because of adipocytes or adipose tissue. Excess nutrients are converted into fat and stored in this tissue. This is like they say most of the bank managers and all will have big belly, no? Because their mental work is more, like their stress is more, but physical work is less. Like they don't have to run and do something, like they have to sit on the chair, and lot of mental pressure is there. So whenever they eat so much and they don't work much, I mean body wise, okay, physical exercise if they don't do, then you know they'll get big belly. No, their body weight also increases. So wherever that extra fat is there, that is all because of adipose tissue. Okay, so any food what they eat, the oily content or lipid or fat content will get stored there. All these nutrients are converted to fat and get stored under the skin, especially in the belly portion. Okay. So, dense connective tissue, we will learn in next class, because already I have taken 36 minutes. After 40 minutes, it becomes two videos. Then I have to join. It takes 2-3 hours extra. Anyway, for one video to record and upload, it takes 3-4 hours. Because in uploading, then premiering, all that extra work and all is there. Okay, so keep watching my classes. Thank you.